Well, I've already seen the film on Netflix and loved it. And I love Peter Tachell. I admire him. He's a hero. He's become a friend in recent years, and that's even better. I think he's heroic. Everything he does impresses me because I would never do it myself. Step into those dangerous places and raise those issues. You'd have to ask the people that really hate him why they do, because I don't.
Do you believe personally yourself that protest does indeed have the power to change the world around us?
Yes, I do believe that. Sometimes we get a little jaded, especially when you're my age, because you've been in so many marches and so many pride parades. But in certain places, it needs to be said, it needs to be seen. And Peter's been going there of late.
And as we look to the future, obviously, in 2021, are there particular causes, particular issues that are most important for you that you would most like to see the fight continue with?
The cause that's number one on my list is trans rights, because trans people seem the most threatened right now. I was shocked when we moved to England 2 years ago, and I was shocked to find a woman reporter at a big newspaper act like that there was some issue that needed to be, you know, she had a problem with it. I don't see how feminism is in any way in keeping with, how do I phrase this? People who call themselves feminists should be for trans people. But some in this country apparently are threatened by it. And so I try to speak out as much as I can. I created a character 40 years ago who was a trans character, maybe the first sympathetic trans character in literature, and I'm sticking with Anna in my support of her brothers and sisters. I think you have to look into your heart on this and ask yourself, how would you feel if you were in the same situation and people were trying to put you down? It's just a question of human decency, really, in the long run. That's the way I see it, anyway. That's the way I've always seen it.
You've obviously been at the forefront of moving that discussion forward. Do you think that creative people, do you think that writers, that storytellers have a responsibility to do that, to move our society forward with those conversations?
I never talk about the responsibility of writers, because a writer's responsibility is to himself or herself. So I don't think there's something you have to do. I had to do it because it became a part of my life. I got to know trans people. I lost friends to AIDS. And I had to write about it. So it's really about the conscience of a writer in the long run.